Hi, welcome back to another episode of FieldFox Fundamentals. I'm David Van Workum.
I'm Jake Daly. Last episode, we looked at network analysis and we took a close look at S parameters. We showed how these S parameters can be used to match two antennas.
And today we're going to continue talking about network analysis and dive into the Smith chart. So I guess the first question is, what is a Smith chart? Now, while these things can look intimidating at first, they're really quite simple. It's just a graphical representation of normalized impedance. Smith charts are used in transmission line theory as well as RF circuit design when designing impedance matching networks. The network analyzer and consequently the FieldFox will use a Smith chart to show complex impedance over a specific range of frequencies.
Yeah, Smith charts can be used to show all kinds of complex quantities. If we look at a Smith chart for complex impedance, from left to right we have 0 ohms going all the way up to infinity ohms. Phase angles that lie above this line represent inductive quantities, and phase angles that lie below this line represent capacitive quantities. So why don't you explain what we have set up here, David?
Yeah, no problem. So we have a FieldFox connected to about a 1 meter long cable. What we're gonna do is check out the Smith chart view of the S11 parameter. So we're gonna go to mode, NA, measure, S11, format, Smith, and we're gonna get our Smith chart.
But that's not really what we're seeing on the screen here.
No, it's not, and the reason is we haven't calibrated. So the FieldFox comes in a cal-ready state where the reference plane for its network analyzer measurements are at the port 1 and port 2 of the FieldFox. So instead of having our device under test or DUT being the open, it's actually this cable, and so that's why we see a lot of changes in impedance over frequency. So what we're going to do is calibrate the FieldFox to move our reference plane to the end of the cable. We're going to go to Cal, and we're going to choose Quick Cal since we don't need any mechanical standards. Then go to Start Calibration. We have an open connection, so we're going to press Measure. And what we're going to expect to see is our impedance shift from all over the place to around infinity ohms. That's once this calibration is complete. We're going to skip this step because we don't want to connect a mechanical standard right now. Press finish. And what do you know? We have our impedance set at around infinite ohms.
And we can verify this calibration by hooking up a 50 ohm load to the end of the cable, and what we would expect to see on the screen would be a perfect match right in the center of the Smith chart, and that is exactly what we see. So this was a very surface level overview of Smith charts. There's a whole lot more out there. We've included two app notes in the description. One goes over Smith charts and the other one goes over calibration.
Yeah, so join us next time where we continue to explore what the FieldFox has to offer. See you then.